My brothers and sisters, I want to welcome you to the Triduum, the three holy days of the Last Supper, of the death, the crucifixion and death of Jesus, and of the resurrection. Tonight, Holy Thursday, we celebrate the Lord's Supper. And just as we remember Jesus and his sacrifice for us, and he is present with us, I pray that you will know that I have remembered and prayed for you, that our staff and ministers are keeping you in our hearts and souls during these days of trial and tribulation.
Let my soul look up with
God, who has called us to participate in this most sacred supper, in which your only begotten Son, when about to hand himself over to death, entrusted to the church a sacrifice new for all eternity, the banquet of his love, grant, we pray, that we may draw from so great a mystery the fullness of love and of life. For we make this prayer through Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, "This month shall stand at the head of your calendar. You shall reckon it the first month of the year. Tell the whole community of Israel, on the 10th of this month, every one of your families must procure for itself a lamb, one piece for each household. The lamb must be a year old male and without blemish. You may take it from either the sheep or the goats. You shall keep it until the 14th day of this month. And then, with the whole assembly of Israel present, it shall be slaughtered during the evening twilight. It shall take some of its blood and apply it to the two doorposts at the lintel of every house in which they partake of the lamb. That same night they shall eat its roasted flesh with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. This is how you are to eat it: with your loins girt, sandals on your feet, and your staff in hand. You shall eat like those who are in flight. It is the Passover of the Lord. For on this same night I will go through Egypt, striking down every firstborn of the land, both man and beast, and executing judgment on all the gods of Egypt. I, the Lord. But the blood will mark the houses where you are. Seeing the blood, I will pass over you. Thus, when I strike the land of Egypt, no destructive blow will come upon you. This day shall be a memorial feast for you, which all your generations shall celebrate with pilgrimage to the Lord as a perpetual institution." The word of the Lord.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, I received from the Lord what I also shared with you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night when he was handed over, took bread, and then he had given thanks, broke it, and said, "This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way also the cup after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink from the cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes." The word of the Lord.
gospel according to John. Before the feast of Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to pass from this world to the Father. He loved his own in the world, and he loved them till the end. The devil had already induced Judas, the son of Simon the Iscariot, to hand him over. So, during the supper, fully aware that the Father had put everything into his power, and that he had come from God and was returning to God, he rose from the supper, took off his outer garments. He took a towel and tied it around his waist. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and dry them with the towel around his waist. When he came to Simon Peter, Simon said to him, "Master, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus answered and said to him, "What I am doing, you do not understand now, but you will understand later." Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." Jesus answered him, "Unless I wash you, you will have no inheritance with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Master, then not only my feet, but my hands and my head as well." Jesus said to him, "Whoever has bathed has no need except to have his feet washed, for he is clean all over. So you are clean, but not all." For he knew who would betray him. For this reason he said, "Not all of you are clean." So when he had washed their feet, and put his garments back on, and reclined at table again, he said to them, "Do you realize what I have done for you? You call me teacher and master, and rightly so, for indeed I am. If I, therefore, the master and teacher, have washed your feet, you must wash one another's feet. I have given you a model to follow, so that as I have done for you, you should also do." The Gospel of the Lord.
My brothers and sisters, tonight we celebrate the three holiest days of the Church, the Triduum. The Triduum is an invitation to enter more fully into the joy and pain, the sorrow and hope, and the loss and new life of Jesus, of his Passover, the Passover of the Lord, of his passion, his suffering, and his death. Our celebration, which begins tonight on Holy Thursday, continues tomorrow, Good Friday, and takes us to the joy of Holy Saturday and Easter Sunday. Jesus' words tonight speak to us like never before. He gives his life to his beloved friends and disciples so that he might remain in us, with us, to be for us forever. I say this as during these days of uncertainty, separation, and confinement, I have come to see how important and how much I need the human touch, to sit close to another person, to hug someone or to be embraced, to reach out and receive the bread of life, or to drink from the cup, the table of the Lord, or to hold the hand of my brother and sister on this desert journey. Beginning tonight, the scriptures and the gospel tell us the story of Jesus' passion, how little by little he is stripped of everything, separated from those he loves, arrested and deprived of his freedom, convicted and robbed of his innocence, sentenced to a cruel an unjust death, tortured and deprived of his dignity, and even his very life is taken from him. But the Word of God tells us that he is left with something precious, and that is that nothing or no one can take from him his love of the Father and his love for you and for me. Tonight's celebration begins after sunset in darkness. Tonight we listen to some of Jesus' last words and teachings, and we meditate on the prayer, O happy fault, O necessary sin of Adam, which gained for us so great a Redeemer. This year, the Triduum calls us to go deeply into the mystery of Jesus' sacred passion. Will we allow God to deepen our faith and dispel our fears and anxieties with the Lord who is always with us? Will we look into our hearts and souls and know that our love for Jesus and one another can never be taken away from us? This Triduum is a call to accept our powerlessness, our vulnerability, with humility and faith and hope, that Jesus' love for us might bring us light in the darkness, and that his love will be our strength, that he is for us, in us, and always with us. Today it strikes me how much we need the Lord to remain with us, and how much our lives are connected by faith and love for each other. How will we who have been stripped of our mobility and our serenity and our stability and our comfort find the presence of the Lord who gave his life so that we might live with him? True God and true man, truly present in the Holy Sacrament, we adore you, O Lord, our friend, our brother, our Savior, God with us, faithful and rich in mercy. We adore you, O Lord. King and Lord of creation and of history, the beginning and the end, we adore you, O Lord. Friend of humankind, the risen and living one who sits at the right hand of the Father, we adore you, O Lord.
Begotten Son of the Father, who descended from heaven for our salvation, we believe in you, O Lord. Heavenly Physician, who bows down over our misery, we believe in you, O Lord. Conqueror of sin and death, Lamb who was slain to rescue us from evil, we believe in you, O Lord. Good Shepherd, who gives your life for the fold you love, we believe in you, O Lord. Living bread and medicine for immortality, who gives us eternal life, we believe in you, O Lord.
Watch over and protect the members of St. Joseph Parish. Deliver us, O Lord. Be with and keep safe the people of New Orleans. Deliver us, O Lord. Gather to yourself your children throughout the world. Deliver us, O Lord. Bless and hold close to your heart all of the elect preparing to join the church. Deliver us, O Lord. Continue to purify and enlighten our brothers and sisters, Billy, Deidre, John, Jose, Judy, Ken, Michelle, Mindy, Richard, and Tim. Deliver us, O Lord.
From the pride and presumption of being able to do anything without you, from the deceptions of fear and anxiety, from unbelief and desperation, from every evil that afflicts humanity, from hunger, from famine and greed.
Save us, O Lord.
From illness, epidemic, and the fear of danger to our brothers and sisters.
Save us, O Lord.
From devastating madness, ruthless self-interest, and from violence.
Save us, O Lord.
Protect your church as it crosses the desert. Comfort us, O Lord. Protect humanity terrified by fear and by anguish. Comfort us, O Lord. Protect the sick and dying. Comfort us, O Lord. Protect doctors, nurses, health care, and personal care assistants exhausted by the difficulties they face. Comfort us, O Lord. Watch over leaders and decision makers who bear the weight of having to make difficult decisions. Comfort us, O Lord.
In the hour of trial and from confusion, grant us your spirit, O Lord. In temptation and in our fragility, grant us your spirit, O Lord. In the battle against evil and sin, grant us your spirit, O Lord. In the search for what is truly good and true joy, grant us your spirit, O Lord. In the decision to remain in you and in your friendship, grant us your spirit, O Lord.
Should darkness oppress us, be our hope, O Lord. Should hatred close our hearts, be our hope, O Lord. Should sorrow visit us, be our hope, O Lord. Should indifference cause us anguish, be our hope, O Lord. Should death overwhelm us, be our hope, O Lord.
Lord Jesus, in this sacrament, you have given us the Eucharist as the memorial of your suffering and death. May our worship of the Paschal mystery help us to experience the salvation you won for us and the peace of your kingdom, where you live with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you. is my way. When I cannot stand, I'll fall on you. Jesus, you're my hope and stay. Lord, I need you. Oh, I need you. Every hour I need you. My one defense, my righteousness. Oh, God, how I need you. You're my one defense, my righteousness. Oh, God, how I need you. My one defense, my righteousness, oh God, how I need you.
My brothers and sisters, tonight we're called to watch and pray, to take some silence as we remember Jesus in the Garden of Gethsemane praying and preparing for his fate, for his arrest and suffering and death. Tonight, if it's appropriate, keeping in mind health and safety and social distancing, perhaps the head of your home may choose to wash the feet of the members of your family. Or if that's not possible because of social distancing, that we might think of people who we can reach out to in spirit and care for by our prayers, by communication, and by our love for one another.